and holy flame. So the world can't see there's a fire in me, burning by the power of your name. Set my faith on fire, that's my one desire. Make my life a pure and holy flame. So the world can see there's a fire in me, burning by the power of your name. Start a blaze, set my faith, faith on fire.
One more time.
Oh, I love that song.
Amen.
All right, it is time to sing our theme song for the weekend. I have enjoyed singing it and getting to know it better. I hope you have too. And as we sing it, we actually have some friends that made hand motions to it. So we're going to have them come right up front.
They're over here, bro.
Oh, never mind.
Check them
out. They're already here, and they have some hand motions to go along with it. But why don't you all stand and join us as we sing our theme song, My Heart Is Yours.
You say the word, and the storm ceases. You sound the call, and there is peace. You say my name, and I walk away. But I'm here to say that's gonna change.
Let me hear you sing.
So today, here is my heart. I don't want it anymore. Before today, you know my heart. I was a control. So take it, break it, shape it into a vessel to carry you to the world. Starting today, my heart is yours. We sing these songs in worship. We lift our hearts as we pray. Won't you take this stone and throw it away? Please cleanse me and set me. So today, here is my heart. I don't want it anymore. Before today, you know my heart. I was under its control. So take it, break it, shape it into a gonna hold back from you anymore. So today here is my heart. I don't want it anymore. Before today you know my heart. I was under
the chorus one more time.
So today here is my heart. I don't want it anymore. Before today you know my heart. I was under its control. So take it, break it, shape it into a vessel. Carry you to the world. Starting today, my heart is yours. So take it, break it, shape it into a vessel to carry you to the world. Starting today, my heart is yours.
Dear Father in heaven, that is our prayer. Lord, you know our hearts better than even we know them. And Lord, we just ask that you would come in into our broken hearts. Take them and shape them into a vessel to carry you to the world, Lord. Bless us now as we have this last meeting for Camporee. And then as we go from here tomorrow, into the world. Lord, I pray that our hearts would be yours and we would make that commitment tonight if we haven't already. Amen.
So take it, break it, shape it into a vessel to carry you to the world. 'Cause starting today, my heart is yours.
Amen.
The Idaho and Montana Conference invite you to stand as we present the colors. Pathfinders, teach, hut. Color guard, forward, march. Post. Present. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Order. Post. March. Post the colors. Color guard, dismiss. At ease, you may be seated.
To the 2012 NPUC Camporee. This is our last evening. My name is Terry Rusk. I'm the Idaho Conference Pathfinder Director, and I want to welcome all of you that came. Our color guard was led by Mr. Bill Legg, Director of the Caldwell Club. Two of his Pathfinders and two Pathfinders from Baker City participated. Thank you.
Wasn't that beautiful? Did you have a good day today? Yeah. Amen. Praise the Lord. How many went to the beach today for the baptism? All right. It was awesome. It was awesome. We're so happy to have you here again. And you know, we're at the final hours of this 2012 Camporee. And we're so glad that you've taken time out of your schedule to be here. And we are having a wonderful time in the Lord. And we just hate to see this time come to an end, but we know that all the people from Alaska, all the folks from Montana, all the Pathfinders from Idaho, all the Pathfinders from Washington, all the Pathfinders from Upper Columbia Conference, and all the Pathfinders from the great state of Oregon, Oregon Conference, are so delighted to be here this evening. And we want to thank all of you, all of the sponsors, all of the bus drivers, all of the van drivers, all of the car drivers, all of the cooks, all of the clubs, and everyone that has made it possible for you to be here this weekend. We want to thank all of them, including your parents and your pastors and your aunts and your uncles and all those folks that you've left back home. We want to give a big shout out to them tonight. Amen. Praise Lord. Can we all say thank you? Thank you. Amen. Amen. Now, you've just heard from Terry Russ from the Idaho Conference, and we have the Montana Conference President that is here with us, Merlin Knowles. Elder Knowles, can you just come on up here and bring us greetings from Big Sky Country, the great state of Montana? All right.
Pathfinders, you having a good time? Just want to give you special greetings from the great sky country of Montana. Did you know that Montana is the fourth largest state in the Union? And Alaska is the largest state? So we got two of the four in this North Pacific Union Conference. Can we give Alaska and Montana a special wave and holler? Just want to bring you special greetings from Montana.
All right, thank you.
Okay, we have a request from the people who can see that there are some holes there. If you could squeeze together a little bit, there's people waiting at the side that like to find a seat. If you could make some room, especially I've heard there's room to be made in the bleachers, squeeze together so those can who are looking to find a seat can find it. Tracy.
On Thursday night when we started our camporee here, we made an offer to the person who posts the best camporee picture on Facebook that they would receive a prize. And the best picture of camporee that we have decided will be on the screen at some point in a few moments, but I would like to invite Sheila Von Bergen from the Cascade Eagles to come forward and receive your prize.
Sheila
Sheila, I'm assuming you're here. Please make your way here. This photo was taken at the Astor Column, and you guys, that is just cool, club. The prize that Sheila is receiving tonight is, first of all, the welcome letter in the middle of your program, signed by Pastor James Black, signed by Pastor Alphonso McCarthy, myself, and by Pastor Ron Whitehead. Come on up. Along with that prize, here you go, along with this prize, you will receive from the Center of Youth Evangelism, they have donated a pass to the Forever Faithful Camporee, and they have donated that to the North Pacific Union Conference Camporee for this prize, and you will receive that prize to go to the Camporee coming in 2 years. Congratulations.
Good job. We're about to see how much fun you have today. The time is right now, ready for the day in review.
Did he hurt you?
And you! You could stop this barbaric outrage by taking what already belongs to you. God has chosen you to right these dreadful wrongs, and will you do nothing?
Enough! I do not know what has come over you. He may be your father, but he is the king, and my household will remain loyal to him. You will never say such things about the king in my house again!
So tonight, what I want you guys to do is I want you to come close, very close, because what we want to do is we want to actually experience what it was like to actually be at the cross itself. This is not about just seeing it on a picture. This is about being there. This is about living that experience. So I want you to come in tight. I want you to come in so you could actually reach out and you could actually touch Jesus.
So Jesus means to me that I'm saved. That no matter how many mistakes I make in life, that I'm going to be forgiven. They're going to be looked at, but then erased. And that I can start a new life over. And that no matter how many times I mess up, I'm still going to get to go to heaven, and I'm still going to get to be that same person that I am, a God's child.
To me is, well, I always thought of him as a guy who was super kind to people, and he helped the poor and the people in need, and I really like that part of Jesus.
Jesus means a second chance.
I'm glad that even though I'm a sinner and I mess up a lot, he will always forgive me, and he's always going to love me, and he will save me no matter what.
He means everything. I love him, he loves me, and he's very special. I will always be there for him, and he will always be there for me. I will always protect him when he protects me.
And then I noticed when I look back, I saw two signs. One said men, one said women. You see, there was nothing wrong with the sign, Pathfinders. The signs were accurate. Men and women. The problem is the signs were clear, but I chose to go in the wrong direction.
Jesus means to me freedom. Freedom from my past, freedom from sin, freedom to be the person that God's created me to be, and ultimately freedom to live forever with Him.
Okay, what does Jesus mean to me? He means everything to me. I cannot imagine life without Him at all.
Jesús significa todo para mí. I mean, Él fue el que me dio la vida. I know que siempre está conmigo y en todo lo que necesito. He's like un mejor amigo para mí, and I guess like you can always count on Him. So, like really, you wouldn't be anywhere without Him. So.
Amen. With the dawn.
Jesus is the savior of all of us. He helps us, and he's a person you could definitely count on. He died on the cross for all of us, me and everyone else. Jesus is God's son, and that means a lot in Pathfinder.
Together, I guess if it weren't for him, I probably wouldn't be in Pathfinders right now. It's still my first week, but I wouldn't have all the friends I have over there, and everyone I love is alive because of him, and all our sins were washed away. I guess that's what he means to me.
Welcome. We have our Montana and Idaho Pathfinders all up here to welcome you and to have you join us. All stand, please, for the Pathfinder song. Oh, we are... Thank you, and you may be seated. Our special features are from all of our clubs singing and the Montanas joining us for a song called Ain't No Rock.
Thank you.
All right, our next song is a combination of our Payette Club with Montana's Butte Club, and they're going to do Sanctuary with Sign Language. We'd like for you to stand at this time and join us for the Pathfinder Pledge and Law. Are we ready, Pathfinders? The Pathfinder Pledge is for me too. The Pathfinder Law is:
by the grace of God, I will be pure, kind, and true. I will keep the law. I will be a servant of God and a friend to man.
Thank you. My memory verse, Emily, and yeah, come on up here, right here. Okay. Amelia and Eli will lead in the memory verse at this time.
I will give you a new heart and put a new spirit within you. I will take the heart of stone and out of your flesh and give you a new heart of flesh. Ezekiel 36:26.
Our prayer will begin with Bianca Pratt from Butte, Montana, and be finished with
Mackenzie
from Butte. Pathfinders, attention. Parade, rest. Prayer, attention.
Dear God, thank you for our beautiful Sabbath day, and thank you for all the fun we had today. Also, please be with us tomorrow on all of our way home. Amen.
Father, we have many prayer requests that have been turned in. So many that want to bring things to you. We think of the pets that are mentioned. We think of the illnesses that were mentioned. Cancer being one of them, one of the hardest ones to fight. Lord, we know you are the great physician and can move in the lives of those who are battling all illnesses. We ask that you will do this. There are family relationship difficulties, divorces, people who are not sure what they want to do with their family relationship. Lord, draw close to them. Know that you love them and every family member
knows that you love them. Work out your will in their lives to honor and glorify your name. Lord, many people have requested for friends and family to make a commitment to God and recommit their lives to God. You know all of these, all these requests especially, and we know that you want that relationship with them. We ask that you move in their lives, because we pray in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Den Hutt, at ease, seats. We would like at this time all the baptismal candidates to come up on the stage, those who are baptized today. We'd have all the candidates, yes, squeezed together. You recognize, not everybody got to the beach. But we wanted you to see everyone that committed their lives to God today.
If you had been down by Sunset Beach this afternoon, you would have been moved from what you would have experienced. And those of you that were there, it was not just another gathering of the beach, but it was a very spiritual occasion. And God just opened up the clouds and sent the sunlight of his grace down upon that spot and sanctified it and made the experience so holy and so transforming. And to see all these individuals that came forward and to take a public stand and to say, I love Jesus and I want him to be my friend and I want to serve Jesus for the rest of my life. I think that was a bold stand, and it was a great stand to be taken at the 2012 Camporee. And so for this, we want to have a special prayer of dedication and commitment for these individuals. And how fitting it is that we have the highest leaders here in the North American Division being here with us today in the form of Elder James Black, who is the Pathfinder Director and Youth Director for the North American Division. And we have Ron Whitehead, also, who is the director for the International Camporee. And because these two men have dedicated their lives to young people and supporting young people and helping to make a difference in their lives, I thought it would be fitting to ask them if they would do this prayer for these individuals this evening. And so I'm going to ask Elder Ron Whitehead if he would go ahead and pray for these individuals, and then I'm going to ask Elder Black also to finish off.
Sure, happy to do that. I'm not going to look at the audience. I'm going to look at the people that gave their hearts to the Lord today. Okay, let's pray together. Father God, there's been a big celebration in heaven. When we arrived at the beach, you were watching what took place there. You're so excited for these young people and adults that have stepped forward and given their hearts to you. I pray right now, God, that you'll send extra legions and the most mighty of angels and put a hedge of protection around each one of them, because the adversary is real, and he's going to try to compromise and destroy their lives and their influence. But we want you to put that hedge of those mighty angels around them. We ask now, Lord, that you that those angels protect them physically. That's very important. But even more importantly, spiritually, don't let the adversary find the weak place. You know, strengthen these young people and these adults as they walk with you. We pray this, of course, in your name, and all the Pathfinders said.
And Father, we continue to just call upon your name, giving you praise, honor, and glory for what we have witnessed today and for what we witnessed tonight. These are actually young people who were not forced, but who made a decision to follow you all the way. And we say thank you so much, dear God, for their decision. And as they've been baptized now, dear God, their journey begins. And we ask that you would pave the way. Not that it would necessarily be smooth, but that you would promise to be with them every step of the way. Be with them in their daily devotion, in their witness to others. As they walk through life, dear God, let them know that you are their God and there is none other.
That's right.
And Father, I challenge them to stay with Proverbs 3, 5, and 6, which says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not into your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your paths. We pray this in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And now I'm going to give the Pathfinders the right hand of fellowship. So I want all of you who got baptized to raise your right hand high real quick. Watch this.
There you go. Go for it. Go for it. That's good.
Come on, Mac. That's the old-fashioned way, man. Come on, put the youth thing into it. You
above all else, of all things most easily wounded, and yet it can never be taken by force.
Long ago, our people vowed to give our hearts to Elohim, the God of Abraham, and he in turn promised them rest. Though few ever dared to keep their vows, the boy David, destined for the life of a shepherd, kept his vow
and put his fate in the hands of Elohim.
This is the story of David, who grew to become a man after God's own heart.
Another dead end.
David, come look at this.
Is it big enough?
See for yourself.
Well done, Joab.
Anything for my king.
No. Remember, Saul
is the king as long as he lives.
Thank you. Now, all right, everyone, this is home. Let's settle in.
Thank you, sir.
I am so hungry. Do you have any more of that temple bread?
You're always hungry. Would you like some bread, brother?
No, thank you. Why did you have to lie about that bread?
Peace. The priest will never know the difference. You know we needed that bread.
David, there's another boy out there looking for you.
Bring him in.
You're welcome. Bring him in. You should hear yourself.
It's just bread, Shamia.
It's sacred bread. I have a bad feeling about this.
Which one of you is David?
Oh, that would be me.
Oh!
You killed my father!
You dare
raise your hand against the Lord's anointed?
What are you going to do? Kill me like everyone else in my family?
Your father, was he a Philistine soldier?
Philistine? He was the high priest.
Ahimelech is dead?
Father died shouting that David would never betray the king.
David wouldn't have run away if the king hadn't tried to kill him.
This is all my fault. I should have listened to Shemaiah. I never should have lied to your father.
Saul killed all the priests. Everyone in Nob is dead except for me.
So sorry. Stay with me. Saul cannot find you here. These men are my family. My brothers, Eliab and Abinadab, and my nephew Joab, and Joshua.
I'm Abiathar. Does Saul want to kill all of you too?
Saul wants to kill everyone who's on David's side.
Like my father. What did you do?
Nothing to Saul, but I still have to hide. I'm a runaway.
Runaway slave?
I was kidnapped and sold when I was 10.
How did you get here?
My master lives in the wilderness of Ziph. When I heard that David was hiding in the wilderness, I ran away to look for him.
I thought you were looking for food when we found you.
That too. My master didn't feed me enough, but I'm making up for it now.
He eats as much as three men.
I've been running for Saul for days. I could eat more than him.
Here.
What happened?
My last fig cake. I brought it from home. Well, my master's house.
Wow, this is great. Hey, I brought something with me, too. I was afraid Saul's men would get it.
The ephod. You carry the word of the Lord.
I am the high priest's son.
No. Ahimelech is dead. You are the high priest. God's blessings go with you. And may his favor shine on us for protecting this, his servant. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Saul is coming. Quick, hide.
Hide everything. Quick. He hasn't seen us.
Excuse me?
You always say he's keen until he dies.
Joab!
If not for you, for us, your men, so we can go home.
My lord the king! You needn't chase me like this anymore. If I wanted you dead, you would be. Look.
My son. I know now that you would never hurt me. I shall promise to never chase you again if you promise to continue to not hurt me or my family.
You are my king. I have already sworn to protect you with my life.
Goodbye, David. As long as the Lord lives, I will never chase you again.
Wait,
was that?
He's the Lord's anointed.
I thought you were.
I will not kill him.
Fine, have it your way. But don't tell me you believe that.
Believed what?
He'll be back with his men. Are you going to be here?
But Saul said that...
Don't tell me you believe that. You know he will.
Fine. Get the men. We will move into the wilderness of Ziph tonight. Ah, home sweet home.
Home?
Huh, it improves with time.
If this is home, I'd hate to go exploring with you.
So hungry.
Sorry, we're out of provisions.
Not again.
Relax. I've sent two of my brothers to talk to Nabal, the sheep lord, and ask him for food.
Nabal? My old master? He never gives anything away, especially not food.
Don't worry. We protected his men from wolves and Philistines. He would be a fool to refuse us.
Nabal means fool.
Goats! Beggars! Slave! How about you take this for asking my master for food?
Heron, hide me!
Peace, man! Must you insist on being as great a fool as your master?
Fool! Is your head bent out of shape? We knock it straight for you!
That'll be enough.
Go ahead.
Thought.
So I take it didn't go well with Nabal.
You saw his overseer. The man was even worse.
But we've protected his men from every harm, have we not?
We didn't ask for your protection.
Then next time you're about to be torn apart by hungry wolves, I'll wait for a polite request.
The time you can protect us from your own imagination, I'll be surprised.
Is that the way you speak to your rightful king?
Oh, king, huh? Yeah, you'll make a great king, begging from your subjects.
Men, get your swords. Nabal thinks we are nothing to fear. Well, we'll visit Nabal tonight. But you will not be there.
On your knees. Any last words, fool?
Saul is coming! He's gonna kill us!
Quick, hide everything!
What do you want done with him?
Deal with him later.
Take him. Not a word, fool, or you die!
Good, my lord.
It'll do. It's as good as any other. Soldier, tell the men to find beds nearby. Abner. We are close. I will be glad to be rid of him.
Yes, my lord.
But not too soon. Oh, not too soon. I will enjoy.
This will never end.
You could end it now.
No, it is a sin.
Is it? You've been given a second chance. Maybe it's a sign.
What would you know about signs? Are you coming?
Yes.
Leave your sword.
Oh, fine. Only if you bring yours.
I cannot kill him in his sleep.
What if you were in your sleep?
David.
No.
Say the word and I will make you king.
No!
Call to the name of the Lord.
Abner!
Who goes there?
You shouldn't have been sleeping. You should instead have been protecting your king.
Never mind the fool, my king. I hear you're safe.
Really? Well, look.
David! Is that your voice, my son?
Your son would like you to let him live.
Oh, David. You know that I would never harm you. I came down here in a fit of rage and it is past. Please, come. Come back to the palace. I swear I will do you no harm.
Come back to the palace? Just send someone over to get your things.
David, come back to the palace, please. No, you know, and you are the only one who can help me when the madness comes. I know you were meant to be king. I would never hurt you, David.
Go in peace, my king.
God bless you, my son.
God's blessing. God's blessing. He's a blasphemer as well as a liar. And you, where are your swordsmen? God do to me and more if one man is left alive in Nabal's house by morning. Watch where you.
Who is she?
Shh. Madame. To what do I owe the honor?
May I speak, my lord?
Of course.
Please, do not listen to my foolish husband.
Your husband?
Nabal. The fool. He acts without thinking. Please, do not punish all of my innocent servants for what he has done.
David, you'll never believe it! Doggies just over the hill, loaded with bread and fig cakes and wine!
Oh, no! Leave him! If you ever trouble these men again, I will deal
what?
With you myself. Sir, a gift. The men who have been so kind to my servants.
Thank you.
We have so much, it is nothing.
No, no. You have saved me from Saul's fate. And I thank you.
Anything for you.
Perhaps I will see you again sometime.
Heron.
Joab.
Yes?
Saul will return.
What of it?
If you will not kill him, then he will kill you.
I know. So we will go to a place that he does not dare.
You mean?
Yes. We leave now and pray that we get to the Philistine camps before the Israelite armies find us. Joab, where are you?
Here.
Where are my men?
Oh, they're in good hands.
Let them go.
To the death. Your men live or die by you, David.
Let them go.
Or what? You'll kill me?
I did what you wanted. Now let them go.
I said to the death. Are you a coward?
You know, I will never kill you.
All I wanted was a duel, David. Just kill me, and your men will be free of all of this. Do it. I dare you.
No!
Of course you couldn't, David. Of course you couldn't. You are a fool, David!
Nothing. It was only a dream. Saul? Even in my dreams, he chases me.
I know how that feels. But we're safe here.
No. We are trapped here. And we cannot leave until... What?
Wait. The king is dead.
Tell us everything.
Saul and Jonathan are dead.
What? How did it happen?
One thing. Who has killed the king?
I did!
Yeah! Excuse me.
Where's Krista? David, time for mourning ended weeks ago.
But he's really gone. What am I to do without him?
Let him go. The people need their king.
People of Israel, your king!
Long live the king! Long live the king!
In order to secure his throne, the king must eliminate all threats. Mephibosheth, son of Jonathan, is the last heir to Saul's throne. Once he is dead, the kingdom will be secure. On your orders, my king!
What are you doing?
I'm securing your throne!
I told you to find Saul's family, not kill them!
He's dangerous!
He is a cripple.
You know what you have to do.
As son of my brother and my friend, this man is under my protection. Anyone who touches him will be treated as if they have laid hand on the king.
Hooray! Yeah! Hooray!
Joshua, will you show our guests to the feast outside?
Yes, Your Majesty. Follow me, everyone. This is going to be the best food you ever eat.
Joab.
Yes?
You will show our honored guest to our finest room. And Mephibosheth, if you need anything, Joab will be happy to get it for you.
I will? Of course I will.
Must be so happy.
I am. The Lord has blessed me with almost anything I could ever ask for.
Almost?
This is a joyful day. I will not darken it with sad tales.
Mikkel!
David, I never forgot you.
I know.
I am. It's a pleasure.
Where do you think you're going?
To record the finest tale Israel's history books have ever seen. Yours.
Let's just not forget who wrote it. Blessed be his name.
Blessed be his name.
And I have a feeling that this tale has only just begun.
You have now witnessed part of David's story and what happened in his life and how God used him. As we prepare to close out this Camporee, I have a question for you tonight. If God called you tonight to be king, how would you lead? Would you be familiar with his voice? Would you know when he's speaking to you? How prepared are you tonight to be king? If God were to call you to... God were to call you tonight, folks, let's get your undivided attention because God is about to do something here, and we don't want the enemy to distract us. Amen? It's been an awesome Camporee, and God is working, but I also know that the enemy has a plan, but we want Jesus to show up tonight. Amen? But if God called you tonight to stand before governments and stand before rulers, are you prepared to do that? You see, somebody might say to you what they said to David at the beginning. Oh, he's too young. He doesn't have the experience. He just takes care of the sheep. But Samuel knew that God had another plan. As I've traveled around the world preaching to young people, I've said to them that when you look at me, know that you're looking at a miracle. Because I consider myself a POG, a P-O-G-G. A POG is one who is a product of God's grace. And I'm going to share something with you now, because if I don't share it with you, many of you may miss your opportunity. Because you might think, well, I'm just a pathfinder, you know, I mean, in my church, I'm really not that significant because everything has to go through the board. And sometimes things that we need don't get voted. So, you know, we're not really that important. But I beg to differ tonight. Because just like many of you sitting in these bleachers, I was sitting in these bleachers also, not knowing what God's plan was for my life. I knew God was going to do something in my life, but I didn't know what it was. You see, Daddy always told everybody that I was going to be a preacher. But I didn't like Daddy for that because I couldn't see it. But Daddy could see it. Tonight, we're going to end the way David's journey began. But before we do that, let me share something with you about why I'm a POG. I told you this morning about the gang violence and those things that took place in my life early on, but there's one thing I didn't tell you. And listen to me very carefully because I don't like talking about this. But I have to tell you the whole truth. You see, my brother didn't make it. My brother, Jesse, died in gang violence at the age of 17. After we buried Jesse, about 2-3 weeks later, the truth came out about his death, and my life was under attack. And I was beaten so bad that those who beat me thought I was dead. But God had my heart in his hand. And what the enemy meant for my bad, God turned it around for his good. And so even though I should have died, and my mother should have gone to another funeral to bury a second son, God said, not today. And I will never understand why God allowed Jesse to die and James to live. But I stand here tonight knowing my purpose. Knowing that I don't have a choice in the matter. I got to do what God has called me to do. So I know that I am anointed to preach the gospel, to bring good to the poor, to set the captives free. I know that. I have no doubt in my mind. And everywhere I go, as long as God gives me breath, I've got to do what he's called me to do. And when God anoints you, it also puts you on the devil's hit list. But the Bible says, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. In essence, the devil cannot punk you out when your heart is in God's hand. And so tonight, Somebody's going to experience something perhaps you've never experienced before. Perhaps nobody has ever laid hands on you to say that God has a plan for you. And I believe that God has a plan for every young person in this building. I don't care how you feel about yourself tonight. Don't judge yourself on your feelings. Judge yourself on the fact that God has a plan for you and you are in that plan. No, don't get me wrong. He doesn't need us. He chooses us. God doesn't need James Black to do anything. God just allows me to participate. And it's an honor and a privilege, so I cannot stick my chest out. I stand before you tonight humbly, saying, give God a chance to touch your heart. Because I'm not a child anymore. I'm not a little kid running up and down the rows of the church in Savannah, Georgia anymore. I'm a grown man. I'm a leader in this church. But I sat where you sat. And God gave me that chance. And so tonight, for those of you who are willing, because we're making this very simple and we just want to get right to it. For those of you who are willing to allow men of God to touch and anoint you tonight, we're going to give you the opportunity to do so. And what you're saying tonight is, God, I just want you to touch me. God, I want you to include me in your plan. God, prepare me tonight at this North Pacific Union Camporee. May this be a beginning for me in my life. Even as a child, somebody said, this was only my first week in Pathfinders. Oh, what a time to allow God to touch your life. You see, let me tell you why we need you, young people. We need you because God is tired of empty Seventh-day Adventist churches. God is tired of every time he shows up, preachers are preaching to more pews than they are preaching to people. And God is saying, I'm going to raise up a generation that's going to change that. Not that full churches is what it's about, but it's about people who haven't heard his message that they're waiting on you to tell them. You don't have to be a pastor. You don't have to be a preacher. But yet, God's going to use some of you in that capacity. You can be whatever you need to be. But God says, I can use you tonight. And it starts tonight. Because I believe in these last days that God is going to raise up children, young people, who will be able to touch the sick and heal them. They'll be able to pray for you and you'll see things change. I believe that young people will possess a power in these last days to do what we as adults have failed to do. But young people, you've got to believe it. And so tonight I've asked the leaders of this camporee, let's do something unique for God tonight. And perhaps what I'm about to suggest will not apply to everybody. This is not a corporate call for everyone to get all emotional and just come. No. It's not about that. It's about somebody, I don't care whether you're 10 years old or whether you're 19. Or perhaps you're an adult and no one ever laid hands on you and you're saying, God, here I am. Send me. God, here I am. Here's my heart. Here's my heart. I'm giving it to you tonight. I want you to take it not for this moment, but I want you to take it for eternity. For eternity. When you are anointed, it's easy to put the past behind you. But what I didn't tell you is that when God anoints you, I was able to baptize the brother of the individual who took my brother's life. Yeah.
God put me in that path. And guess what, everybody? I'm so glad he did. I'm so glad he did. So tonight, you want your testimony to be that the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. And so tonight, we're going to ask that we have all our pastors here. And they're going to come and we have oil. For those who desire, this is not something being forced upon you. This is by choice. That if you're 10 years old, 11, 12, 13, whatever your age, you're just simply saying, God, I want you to touch me tonight. And we're going to ask all our pastors, if you would, all our pastors in the audience, would you please come forward quickly, please? We don't want any talking. We don't want any movement. All our men of God, please come quickly. Quickly, brethren. Quickly. Because somebody's about to experience something perhaps they've never experienced before. And for those of you who believe, I want you to pray in your hearts right now that God will do something extraordinary. We need more than that. We need about 12 more. Do we have any elders? Just come join us. We need about 24 at least. Quickly, quickly. And now what I want you to do, as they're coming, if you've heard the voice of God through this camporee, and you're saying, Pastor Black, man, I've heard God's voice, and I don't want to miss out on anything. I want to be included. I want to be included in this awesome plan of God. I want to be set aside tonight to do great things for him. And this was David's story, but what's going to be my story? Man, God is going to use you in a mighty way. Oh, he's going to use you. Some of you are going to preach around the world. Some of you are going to create things. Some of you are going to write great books. Some of you are going to baptize thousands of people. Some of you are going to be great doctors, great educators, all kinds of things. But you want to make sure God is in the middle of everything. And so tonight, you want to stand wherever you are. And so Pastor Black, you're talking to me tonight. Hallelujah, young lady. Anybody else? Wherever you are, hallelujah. And brethren, as they stand in the balcony, in the upper area, as you see them stand, just go to them and serve them. Throughout every part of this audience, let us just spread ourselves quickly. There should be no talking. Those who are not standing, please pray. Please pray. Bow your heads and pray. If you're not standing, bow your heads and close your eyes and pray for those who are standing. Oh, yes, I see an entire club standing. Hallelujah. Anybody else? This is your time tonight. It's very simple. It's not difficult. It's just your choice. Say, God, my heart belongs to you tonight. Hallelujah. Anybody else? You're thinking about it. You're thinking about it. Don't think about the person sitting next to you and what they might think. No, this is your moment to stand for God. Amen. Somebody just stood. See, don't be distracted. Don't be distracted. Be focused. Because it's between you and God. It's between you and God. Anybody else? Maybe you've stood before they pass you. If you've not been anointed, just raise your hand and they'll come back for you. Look around, brethren. Amen. There's some up front that just stood. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Some of you will never forget this camporee. You witnessed a baptism today and those who went all the way. And tonight, some of you are being laid hands on in the name of Jesus. Saying, God, I'm being set aside tonight to do great things for you. If a little boy with 5 loaves of bread and 2 small fish, if this lunch can be used to feed 20,000 people, just a little bit, it doesn't take much. Wait until I show you before this prayer what I'm going to show you. It doesn't take much. It doesn't take much. I see them praying. In my Bible, because we're going to pray in a minute, but we're going to make sure we're not missing anybody. I don't want to disturb the prayer, but I want to show you something. In my Bible, everybody, I walk with something. I carry something everywhere I go. Just know that every time you see James Black, just know I carry something that will always be with me. And in my Bible, here is what I carry. Can you see this? Here's what I carry, everybody. Can you see this? For those of you who can't see this, this is a mustard seed. It's a mustard seed. It is so tiny, you cannot see it. And God says, that's how much it takes to move mountains. Something so tiny you cannot see it. If you drop it, you'll lose it. And God says, that's how much it takes. And he says, with this, nothing shall be impossible for you. If there are problems in your family, and your mother and your father not acting right, get on your knees and call on the name of Jesus, because it doesn't take much. If there's no family devotion in your house, then when you get back home tomorrow, you start it, because God has called you. You see, young people, you can't wait on anybody anymore. God says it's your time now. And guess what? Nobody's going to make it easy for you. I get emailed all the time, people saying, young people should not be preaching. Young people should not be on platforms. Young people should not be teaching. All these kinds of things. But David stood up anyhow. Everybody was running when Goliath came out. But David said, no. Who is this uncircumcised Philistine defying the armies of the living God? You can say that when you've been anointed. Hallelujah. Somebody say hallelujah. We're about to pray. If we've missed somebody tonight, just raise your hand, because I want one of the ministers to come and touch you. If we missed you, just raise your hand. We missed some folk over here, right over here. Got a whole group right there. We're about done, everybody. We're about done. We're not going to prolong it. We're not going to be here all night. It's just either you're going to stand boldly for God and say, Lord, here I am. Because somebody was touched tonight who's never going to forget it. God showed up for you tonight. God showed up at this camporee. And folk have been praying all over for you. And God has answered some prayers tonight because you stood. North Pacific Union is in good hands now, because you've got some anointed young people here. Somebody didn't hear what I said. You've got some anointed young people here. Oh, yeah. The devil can't punk you out now. Or he knows God's got something on you now. And you won't run. And as you begin your journey with God, go all the way. Don't let anybody set the standard for you but God. I know what my job description is at the North American Division, but it does not keep me off the streets of Washington, D.C. I know what my job description is, but it does not keep me off the streets of Baltimore. I can't help myself. At my house now are individuals who need to be there, because they cannot go anyplace else. Yes, I practice what I preach. My neighbor said to me, man, you got some strange people coming in your house. I said, I was strange at one time too. But he's a believer now. Hallelujah. Y'all didn't hear what I said. I'm determined to do my part. Be determined to let God do his part in your life. I think everybody is done. There's some who, okay, brother, we got some over here with their hands up. We don't want to miss anybody. And we got some over here to my far left. My far left. My far left. Just touch them quickly and keep moving. Amen. Pray, everybody. Pray, everybody. Pray, everybody. Some of you may not understand what's going on. Because, see, I hate to say it because there's some things we don't practice often enough. This should not be a strange thing tonight. Yeah, we have baptism and we have communion, but it's rare that many of you ever witness an anointing. Jesus chose his 12. And pretty soon you're going to be hearing about how you can choose your own 12. Because God is trying to wrap this thing up, everybody. He's trying to wrap it up. He's trying to wrap it up. The world is going crazy. Look around, everybody. It's going crazy. Soon and very soon, this thing is going to be over. But God needs you to be a part. Here's a young man right here. Hallelujah. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. That's what I'm talking about. Hallelujah. 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 This wasn't planned. This wasn't part of the program, but we had to follow the directions of God. And this is what God said, do. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That little boy who stood just now, I don't know what God's plan is for his life. Young man, come here. Young man, come here. Have him come here. Come here. Come here, son. Have him come here. Somebody bring him here. Bring him here. Come here. Come here. What's your name? Huh? I saw you stand just now, man. I saw you raise your hand. And I saw them anoint you. And son, I don't know what God's plan is for your life, but I believe God's got a great plan for your life, okay? Just keep your hand in God's hand. I believe God's going to let you grow, and you're going to be a mighty, powerful young man for God. And I want to give you this mustard seed. And Jesus talks about this in the Bible, that it's a little seed, but when you plant it, he says it grows so big that its leaves spread and birds can hide under it. And he says, that's how much faith you need, just a little bit, to trust in me. So you keep that in your Bible. You keep it with you always, okay? And I'm going to be praying for you that God use you in a mighty way, okay? God bless you, man. God bless you. Believe in these children. And we as a church have not always done right by them. We've got young adults right now that don't want to have anything to do with this church. They're tired of our battles over the issues that they're tired of being beaten over the head with the spirit of prophecy and making Ellen White a policewoman, and that's not the purpose of the spirit of prophecy. They've been told that if they don't change their dress and all this kind of stuff, they're not going to heaven. And we focus on everything except for the heart. But God says to these children, I want you to change some things. So pick up my word and get in my word. And in closing, get on your knees and get to know me. The last thing I want to say to you before I get on the road and drive to Portland tonight. Young people, as you give God your heart, get to know him. He says, I know my sheep, and they know me. When they hear my voice, they I'm determined to continue following Jesus. Tonight, I challenge you to continue following Jesus. Eternal Father, our God, I'm told that hallelujah is the highest form of praise. So tonight I want to say hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord, somebody even once told me to be careful how I say hallelujah because that's Pentecostal. Well, tonight I'm Pentecostal. Because I praise your name for showing up, God, and showing out and showing us who God is. That even a small child can recognize the importance of tonight's emphasis. And a child can stand up and raise his hand and say, don't forget about me. I want to be included. This anointing is not no kind of fake situation. It's about eternity. So God, I pray of what you've said in Acts 1:8, that we shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon us, and we shall be a witness throughout this entire world. So now tonight, in the name of Jesus, we claim that, Father, for every young person here. And for the one who did not stand, continue to bless that life. Continue to lead that life. That they'll continue doing what they got to do. It's not by separating anybody tonight who didn't stand. That's not what this is about. Because many who did not stand, they're closely connected with you, Father, and I understand, and I thank you for that. But, Father, show up in this union, and may those who've been anointed tonight impact this entire world. That wherever they go, every man, every woman, every boy and girl will know that they have been with Jesus. We claim this promise in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit, and the entire North Pacific Union Camporee said, amen, amen, and amen. Hallelujah.
You think back just a few days here, you know, we started with this whole presentation and I give my heart to, you know, Jesus. Started the first night there with this great Bible presentation every night. Pretty impressive, wouldn't you say? All the young people put this together. Can we give them a hand of applause? They're back there. Very impressive. Something, a little secret, a little bit of a secret. I have the opportunity, Pastor Black and sometimes Jonathan Tell. We get to travel representing Pathfinder Ministry all over the world. And I'm here to report to you, this is a world-class union camporee. And for all the leaders, Pastor Mac, Pastor Terry, all the youth directors in our union here, can we give them a big affirmation, a hand of applause for all their work? Outstanding. Outstanding. The stage, the venue. And I don't know how they did this, but they got the weather right, too. I mean, the weather is great. I mean, this is just my kind of camporee. But Pathfinders, you know what else is going on? There's some area coordinators that help organize this with all the other leaders. There's some Pathfinder directors, club directors out here tonight, and staff. And when I was a little kid, now I'm a big kid, but when I was a little kid, I didn't understand. These people take vacation time. Sometimes they take money from their pockets to make sure you get to these camporees. I didn't realize that when I was a little person. Now I got it figured out. And for Pathfinders that are shorter than me, can you give a big hand of applause and a shout out for all the adults that brought you here? Yeah, please do that. Pretty impressive. Pretty impressive. World-class camporee right here. North Pacific Union. Now there's another camporee coming up. Very soon, I'll tell you about in just a moment. But this afternoon, when I drove out to, you know, be a part of this baptism, I thought there might be, North Pacific Union might show up with, maybe 75, 150 people. I drove out on the, I've never been to the Pacific Ocean up this far north, and they say you can drive your car out there, and if you have a little car like I do, it just, and so you look for friends and all, but I kind of made it, got out there. There's a huge crowd off to my right when I came out to the beach. I wondered, well, what's going on there? Well, I mean, there must be some kind of big gathering, or who would be out here on the beach? It did not dawn on me. You all showed up so you could support the Pathfinders who are out there being baptized. I'd like to give them a hand of applause. All the kids are baptizing adults today. Yeah. Give their heart to Jesus. Heart to Jesus. My heart to Jesus. So, after the baptism, I grabbed my wife, Betty. I'm so glad she came. And I went down to this other part of the beach. There's some kind of a shipwreck from 1909. I had to see it. I had to see it. I like things that wreck. And I had to go there. And so I went out. I found it. Got out there. Sure enough, walking out there to that big piece of metal, you know, getting a picture, you know, and sent it to my son and my kids and stuff like that. I was there. And I went out there. And Betty looks at me and says, do you see that? See what? On the beach. I said, what? And she said, look right there. And there's the big, big text across the beach. Pathfinders. They're everywhere. Pathfinders are everywhere. And so, and I look underneath it. She found another thing, a big writing out there. It says, my heart for Jesus. My heart for Jesus. Out there on the beach today. Isn't that cool? Really cool. Really cool.